Hey, what's up, guys? Thanks for stopping by. I appreciate your time. This is what I got in this month and a little bit of the previous month. So here we go. First up is Volume 4, five films, 5 years. I just collect the horror and exploitation themed ones. So this is, I have Volume 2 and this is Volume 4. So they've only released two of these so far. A few of these are upgrades, like Vampire Hookers. I can't remember if I've already had Evil Come, Evil Go, but definitely Vampire Hookers and Cry Wilderness, which Cry Wilderness comes with another Bigfoot-themed movie, but I can't think of it off the top of my head. But so that's that. Pretty cool. I like what they're doing with this kind of thing. It's a great idea. It saves on shelf space as well. And then finally getting around to this movie, I've had my eye on it for a number of years. Extremely late to the party, but better late than never. So that is Adam Chaplin. This is, I'm not familiar with Autonomy Pictures. I'd have to look into them and see what else they've released, but much older edition of Violent Avenger. So cool. Awesome. And then finally getting around to the original Assault on Precinct 13. I've only seen bits and pieces of this movie throughout the years. I have yet to like watch it the whole way through. I've always just caught it on like TBS or something like that. So I'm looking forward to finally watching this all the way through. There is one scene in the beginning of this movie that has stuck with me over the years, and that's where the car pulls over, window rolls down, a gun comes out, and a kid just gets shot in the face, like point blank. So a scene like that, just at least for me, has just stuck with me for years. So I'm looking forward to, anyway, it's crazy, but anyway, looking forward to finally checking this out all the way through this time, and very happy to finally have it in my collection now that I'm sort of collecting more and more thrillers and stuff like that. So here we go. Pretty cool. I'm not a big fan of the remake. I just thought it was very lackluster compared to what I have seen bits and pieces of that. I didn't like the new one that came out several years back. I think that was more of an action movie. But anyway, continuing on. The special effects in this one look awesome. It sort of reminds me of 90s horror in a way. So I'm looking forward to checking out Asylum of Darkness. I'm not too familiar with this director, but didn't that look cool? I mean, yeah, I just couldn't resist. I had it on my wish list for quite a bit. So Asylum of Darkness, Burn on Demand, you know, Blu-ray disc, that kind of, you guys know how it is with some of these. So that's that. The Backlot Murders, I haven't seen this in forever. I know this is one of those old horror movies. It's had a DVD release. I've just never gotten around to getting that DVD, but none of that matters now. So pretty cool to finally score a copy of this into the collection. So awesome. I just like the location and everything that this movie takes place in. So pretty cool. Definitely using the Psycho House again. I thought that was pretty neat. Call Girl of Cthulhu, a re-release, and from the same company, Camp Motion Pictures. So this is their second time re-releasing this movie onto Blu-ray. I have the first Blu-ray edition, but I really didn't need to go for this again. Maybe this has got way more special features this time. I'd have to look on my other edition. I think it does. But the cover art to this new one is it's awesome. I couldn't resist. So I think it's pretty badass. So, and it's a fun movie. So I'm a big fan of the movie. So double dip already on like a really new movie. And this seemed interesting. I'm not going to be able to say that right. Kanoa, A Shameful Memory Based on a True Story. It just seems bonkers to me. So, a movie from the 70s. I'd never heard of it, but until now, thanks to Criterion. So, that's that. The Case of the Scorpion's Tail. Really beautiful edition. coming from Arrow. I love this cover art. It's very beautiful. And really neat. I'm sure everybody and their grandmother's shown this off by now, but how could you not? It's pretty cool. So one of my favorite giallos. I need to revisit this, though. It has been a while. So, upgrade. Next is a documentary that I had never heard of. It has been released onto DVD before, but this seems to be a bit of a better edition. I believe the first one was an independent release, I think DVD-R or something like that, with much better cover art, I'd have to say. This is a newer cover art coming from Wild Eye here, but pretty cool. So this is a re-release. It has been released on a DVD before. Not that I've ever known that. I just kind of looked into it and found that out when doing more research about this documentary. So Children of Dracula, those who claim to be actual real vampires. So that's interesting. Sort of reminds me of Martin in a way, I guess. That's that. I like the documentaries on that kind of stuff, so. The Church, beautiful edition. I love the poster that it came with. I had to frame it and hang it up for sure. A big fan of the guy's art, and just, I love this movie. Just that nuts. This has so many nutty scenes, especially with Demon on the Table having its way with that one girl. It's crazy. So, The Church, just one of those movies I have to get over and over again. So, awesome. Beautiful edition, thanks to Scorpion. I believe that's Scorpion that released it. Yeah. And then, first time for me, I just never had this in my collection. I'd been wanting to see this movie for years, and that's Combat Shock. It just looks nuts. So, I had been wanting to check this movie out forever. So, such a crime. I never got around to this movie until now. So, a beautiful edition. Came with a nice book, which surprised me. I wasn't expecting it to be as thick as it is. I mean, that's really nice. So I'm looking forward to reading this for sure. Like bathroom material. So that's that. Combat Shock. Upgrade. This movie's awesome. Definitely digging the new artwork for it. From what's his name? Osborne. Pretty cool. I like the greens and everything. Fits the movie quite well. Awesome. So, no brainer. Had to get it. Really cool special effects in this one. So, some more H.P. Lovecraft goodness. And this scene, pretty cool. I just watched the trailer. Complete. Just a blind buy. It looked like a cool slasher in the snow type horror. So, The Dark Below. Of course, I had to go on eBay and snatch this up. So, it's one of those horror pack exclusives. It's got an autograph. Really cool. So, that's that. And then I've been keeping my eye on this movie for a while, but it's a shame that it's been getting a lot of bad reviews. But I still wanted to take the plunge and check it out myself. I do like the original title better, which is, I believe, is called Beautiful People. I've just had my eye on it because the zombies in this movie look awesome. They just look like a ton of fun. So there you go, right there. But not a lot of positive reviews, unfortunately, for this movie. I'm hoping I'm still going to get some enjoyment from it. But we'll see. So that's Dead House. This one's also released by Wild Eye. So I just couldn't resist, even with the reviews and everything. And I gotta see for myself. So that's that. Devilfish, finally. So that's awesome. Also known as Monster Shark and Devouring Waves. I just love the way the creature looks in this movie. It's a bit slow, but I've always liked this movie. So really awesome that movies like this are finally getting a really nice release. So, pretty cool. So, thanks, Code Red. And then, I've just been on the fence about this movie for the longest time. I know the CGI in this is a bit weak, but I'm just intrigued by the story itself and the fact that it has a bit of the true story mixed in with it about the 1959. What happened to, like, as you can see there, read there about it, with the Russian hikers going missing and then found, bodies found, and it's just a complete mystery up until, to this day. So, the movie itself, I've always read, like, mixed reviews, mostly just sort of okay. But anyway, Devil's Pass, let me know what you guys thought of it. I got it for like used and pretty cheap, so that's that. Don't Grow Up, this looks interesting. I do plan on watching this pretty soon. I was meant to watch this actually this past weekend, just did not gotten around to it yet. But Don't Grow Up, their days are numbered. Pretty cool. At least sounds cool. And then Doom Asylum. It's nostalgic, and I just like the kills, and it doesn't quite all make sense. But it's just amazing that Doom Asylum gets this treatment. This is just insane. So we are definitely spoiled these days as collectors, for sure. I would have never thought a movie like this would get such an addition. So thanks, Arrow. That's awesome. So Doom Asylum, awesome 80s special effects and just a nutty slasher movie that doesn't make quite sense, but that's it. Pretty cool. Enter the Devil, another awesome release from Masker Video, so that's cool. I haven't grabbed any Masker Video in a while, so it was really cool to finally get something new from them. I love the slip box design, that's pretty sexy. And it'll be a first time watch for me. I've never seen this movie before, and I don't think I've had this movie in my collection before, unless it goes by another title. I know it does, but I can't remember. But that's that. Enter the Devil. Documentary I've been wanting, that's been on my wish list for a while. It's just the original DVD. I think Anchor Bay released it. I don't remember. Some years ago. It's just been long out of print. So I'm pretty glad that this got re-released. I'm pretty sure it'll be added as a bonus feature eventually with like a nice Hammer Blu-ray box set. But for now, I am satisfied for just at least having a copy of this. It's just one of those documentaries I've been wanting to see for quite some time. So that's Flesh and Blood, the Hammer Heritage of Horror. So more Hammer, so that's awesome. And then a very slow drag of a movie, but I couldn't help myself. And I love the AGFA, which stands for American Genre Film Association, in conjunction with Something Weird Video. I'm addicted to collecting what they release, if it's horror or just the weird sort of borderline horror. This is not a really good movie at all, but I just had to get it. And it's a twofer. Comes with The Legend of Bigfoot, so that's awesome. So God Monster of Indian Flats. And I love that cover art. I just love how amateur and just I hate to use this word, but I can't help it, just cheesy looking it is. It fits the movie, it really does. So and it reminds me of cover art that I've seen before and like video stores back in the day. But yeah, that's that. Blind Buy from SRS Cinema. This looks to be pretty like a lot of fun. A little bit of gore here and there. So Grim Places. I'm not sure what to expect. So I'm looking forward to checking this out. I think it's a German splatter. I could be wrong. I don't remember. But that's that. Grim Places. Upgrade. Beautiful edition hardware. I love the simplistic slip cover to this. This is beautiful. This is one of the most beautiful slip covers in my collection so far. I just love how simple it is. And this is very hard to... Pretty cool. Original cover art. Awesome movie. Pretty cool. Killer... Another one of those killer robot movies that you gotta have. And very atmospheric. The setting of this movie is awesome. So, that's beautiful. Very beautiful addition. So, again, I think this is Scorpion that released it. I don't remember. Yeah, I think. I got it from Ronin. So, that's that. Pretty cool. And then another one, Hell House, as in another blind buy. Hell House LLC. This has been recommended to me from quite a few people. So it looks crazy. It does look creepy as all get out. So awesome. This sort of reminds me of I'm a little late to the party with this one for sure. Got this one for pretty cheap too. One of my local video stores, pretty used copy, in good condition. It reminds me of what I just watched. What's that latest movie? It's late and I don't remember. A Quiet Place. It sort of has that same storyline to it. So I'm gonna check it out. It looks to be pretty cool. So The Housemaid. Don't know what to expect. It looks. I don't know. I'll check it out. House Shark, pretty fun movie. I enjoyed the heck out of it. I love the way the shark looks, and this is a really nice addition. Again, this is coming from SRS Cinema. I got some autographs here. Pretty cool. And glad to have this. This is a blind buy, and it totaled out to be a lot of fun, and pretty funny too. So I like that. And just to let you guys know, I did do a, I forgot to mention this last time when I was showing a bunch of new toys and whatnot. You can go on, just a little bit of a plug, sorry. Me and Eric over at his channel is the Horror Man Cave. I sculpted for SRS Cinema, I did some sculpt work for them. I sculpted a house shark. So, and they are selling this on their website. So if you're into that kind of stuff, they're pretty limited, but check it out if that seems like your cup of tea. If you really do, you know, if you're enjoying the movie and you want to get, you're into collectibles and stuff, get you one of these. These are pretty cool. Mine's a blank copy. They do have like painted kind and some that come in a variety of colors with like a really cool black wash paint scheme over it. So pretty proud of that. This one took a while to sculpt and make, but Eric did a fantastic job with the paintwork and making resin copies out of these for sure. So that's that. That's that little sort of plug. Had to mention that just for who might be interested in getting you one of those house sharks. I'm a terrible salesperson. I'm just always bad about that. So I am a hero. I've heard nothing but good things about this. It's one of those, if you like that other movie that's sort of like this. The name of that movie escapes me. It came out not too long ago. Based on a... it'll come to me. I don't remember. But I'm looking forward to checking this out. I've heard nothing but good things about this one. So finally got to get a copy. And this seems to be like a really nice addition too. Pretty cool. So that's that. Getting around to this. This looks like a lot of fun. I didn't come here to die. It just looks to be really funny about these guys are like a cleanup crew, cleaning up and maintaining trails in the woods, something like that. I don't remember. And they just sort of accidentally injure themselves with the tools that they work with. And it just looks to be a lot of fun to watch. So that is that. I'll get to the second stack when I can next. So again, guys, I appreciate your time, and thanks for watching. Be sure to catch the second part later.